Good evening, everyone. Oh my god, it seems that I didn't talk anything today. Right, good evening and welcome to the beer and game and banter and some banter. My name is Donis. Welcome whoever joins me tonight. I see Christy X4 is there. Welcome, thank you for joining. I know there will be like triple streaming in different channels, outdoor streaming, GOG streaming, so, oh well, life is life. Hello Darkness, welcome. Right, where's my game? There's my game. Here.
I don't mind,
so we have more music. Right. Cool, so I decided to continue playing Contrast today because it's a really interesting concept game, and it really interests me, and I want to see, you know, the story is just the simple, nice story, and I expected it to be some easy late night game just to play for relaxing and all that stuff, but it will be, apparently it is some kind of a 3D platformer, which is, wow, it completely surprised me and caught me unprepared. So hopefully today I will move past all of those places where I was stuck last time. Yeah, I'm playing with the controller in this game, and it can be played with keyboard, but it's a bit easier with controller, right? A little bit about the story. It's we're playing as Dawn. This is Dawn, and we are in this little girl's imagination, who is called Didi, and we're just trying to help her to kind of connect her mom and dad and help them to become together. And yeah, that's basically the main idea of the story. I want to leave you with this nice view. Let me just run to it. And this nice moon and the ship. Right, at least I have some beer. Yeah, Classicor has pizza on GOG's channel, and he's doing some classical pen and paper RPG, I think. And that's actually a very interesting thing to see also, so I definitely will watch his VOD. Tonight I have a beer like filled in the glass, because I bought an example of some small Polish brewery, which is called Spirifer, or it's actually like an animal, not a butterfly, but something in that direction. So that's what the name represents, and it's a very small one. They don't have any bottled beer, so they have, you know, the beer from the tap. And in Poland, it's like there's very little amount of shops where you can actually buy a beer in a plastic bottle, and you know, as it is from the tap. Yeah, but I got lucky, and today I just bought one. So I didn't try it. It's an Indian pale ale. Yes, it's an Indian pale ale. So, cheers, mates. Very nice. Very IPA type of beer. It's like, now IPAs are very bitter beers, and they are made from a few types of hops, which are pretty bitter, and some of them are unbearable bitter. Some of them have this nice citrus taste. You can call it even grapefruit. And yeah, it's pretty nice. Cool. So we will be enjoying this tonight. Alright, so I think we have repaired one attraction, so we have two more left in this game. And let's check them out. Oh, I think I did not collect this thingy. Right, I have to remember how actually to play. And the game just froze? What? Oh, come on! Huh? Ah, okay. Everything is okay. Thank you. I like my dual triple hop. Oh yeah, that's bitter. I like triple hops, not all the time. Yeah, but there was some time when I actually just discovered this IPA. No, wait, I forgot the controls. Let me just look it up very fast. Dash is B. Okay, this is interact, blah blah. This is shift and focus spotlights. Cool. Welcome, Nubilandery. From IPA beers, I usually go for BrewDog beers. Oh my god, man, I love BrewDog. You cannot imagine. Like every single time I see a BrewDog somewhere, I just go for it. It's freaking expensive, usually, at least here, and it was expensive in Lithuania also. So it's not a very cheap choice. And I failed. But I love them. I really, really love them. Actually, I did not finish the pirate ship because I just got stuck on that. So I love the punk IPA from BrewDog. I'll just have to get back. I couldn't play this during the week just because you cannot continue and just, you know, have separate saves. Oh. So I could not practice. Ah. Damn, why is this so hard? I still have the stream stars fever. Right, I have to wait for this thing. Why did I actually dash out? I shouldn't just dash out of the shadow. Let me check. Whoops. Come on, concentrate. This is an easy game. I think I'm distracted by the those legs. I have a suspicion. Wait, so okay. Let's dash. So if I, okay, so I can dash. That's not a problem in the shadow. So did I just accidentally press shift out? Oh crap. That might be the case. Yeah, let me know how you hear me, by the way. If it's okay, too loud, too quiet. Huh. Alright, we're waiting. We need to jump and dash. And we dashed too far. There's like no easy way to control this in the game. Damn it. Anyway, guys, what kind of beers do you like? I see that Nubilander likes stouts. Andy was, of course, and Brewdog, you're my man. Yeah, I wonder, like, how much does it cost in other countries? Like, which countries are you from? Because here it costs like, let's see, around 17 zloty. Oh no! Come on! It costs around 17 zloty for 0.3 bottle, which is a lot. I paid for a pint of Brewdog. I paid 8 euros in Italy. Yeah. Oh man, I found the Brewdog bar there. That was so amazing. Unfortunately, I had only one night to spend there. Yes. And yeah, I couldn't spend more time in there, unfortunately. Cool. We made it. Did you see? We made it! And it doesn't matter right now. I could have died in there. Okay, I have the luminary. Okay, so I have the pirate ship, and I think I'll go for pirate ship. We ended there last time, so unfortunately, we'll have to start from the beginning, which is
oh, look at that!
Oh,
this
Nubilandri is in Finland. It's like 15
the
to 25.
Stuck up there. How do we get on board?
Are you kidding me? 25 euros. Please tell me at least it's for 0.5. Dude, I heard that alcohol is super expensive in there, but 25 euros? My oh my. Oh, I didn't have to shift out. Ta-da! Here we
Captain
go, bridge is lifted!
Avast there, first mate! Anchors away! Let's heave ho! And hoist the mainsail!
I now need this box for some stuff, so I will take it right now. Because we finished this part from the last stream.
Aww, it's closed! Can you open it?
Aww, of course, Didi. It'll be very fast. Drop this one. And right now we have to. Oh, no, I can't. What? I want to shift in. So I can shift in. Come on, game. No, I can't. Any game. Oh, right. There's another box somewhere, so we'll find it. Doesn't matter. Hey Grievix, thank you for joining. You didn't like the alien isolation? Why? Well, it's scary, but it's not that scary, right? thank you very much for joining. Wait. What I need to do here? Oh, no. Yes, now we have to... Yes. Voila. How do you remember this stuff? This is awesome. And we have more luminaries. That is very good. Oh! She played the automaton. Okay, now I understand. That's a very interesting device, actually. Yeah, that's cool.
Second star on the right and straight on till morning.
Noiton. Welcome, Memories in 8-bit. Welcome. Is that really so annoying? It's like, you know, kind of annoying, but not that much. And you can play some interesting melodies with that. You know, it's like... If you're thinking about a music instrument that you actually could take on stream... Take a guitar, right? So guitar is a huge bulky stuff, and usually streamers have tons of stuff around themselves. Like, I have, you know, this laptop nearby where you see the chat and part of my stream that you actually shoot. Yeah, here's some old stuff, some lamp, here's my phone.
Isn't it supposed to attack us or something?
And, yeah, it's like, for me to, for example, take out the guitar, I would have like to go in some way down here and just grab it. Other instruments are like, I don't know, some flute, probably, or something else. Can we jump in the box? No, I want to jump in the box. I got an achievement for jumping in the box. No backpack bird needed. That's nice. Yeah, so you can take a flute or maybe, I don't know, some lesser instrument, but bulky ones, they're hard to reach. Annoyeton. Yeah, that's a perfect name. That's true. Hello, Patrick1234. And Alphador from Gokom. I see this pilot from the pilot in this
fire when you are ready, Ridley.
So, yeah. Someone mentioned me there. Just wait.
Isn't the bow supposed
to
shoot it again?
Ocarina. What is Ocarina? What is that? Okay, so in order to shoot this, we have to get to way up there. How did I jump here? Huh. There we go. Here we are. Huh. And I have the bowl. Okay. That's not a very strong door. Wait a minute, I'll get to a save location. Check that out. Oh my god, that looks so alien. That seriously looks so alien. Nice. Nice. I bet it sounds a bit better than Automato. Nice, nice. Mikeller and Nogne are awesome too. Yeah, Mikeller makes very amazing beers, and they're even more costly than BrewDog ones. So they're really, really costly, and they make a lot of interesting beers. I actually still did not try a lot of them. I tried like a few of them, but yeah, for some reason I'm still aging myself to try Mikeller beers. So are we firing again? Padam. Alright. Awesome. We're free to go.
Yeah, take that! Go back where you came from, you big squid!
You
go
big
find
squid.
A whale to pick on!
Go find a whale to pick on. Oh, that's so smart, Didi.
Oh no! Wait, it's a whirlpool! He's sucking us down!
Yes, Padak, I have been to England.
Yar,
Davy Jones is taking a dive for us. Oh my god, what is that? The eye has caught us. Deliver the final blow. Oh, so we're fighting this huge tentacle monster. This is awesome. This is very awesome. Yeah, so I was in England multiple times. I was once as in school. I was in Essex, and it was just learning stuff. I was in London last summer for a couple of days, just visiting there. I went through half of Scotland with friends by the car. We visited a lot of Scotch places, so that's when I got my acquaintance with the whiskey. Yeah, probably that's... I visited Blackpool also. I don't know what else. Wow, Chris wants to learn that so bad. So, you know, if you learn this... did I jump into it or what? No? Do I have to pick something for that? Oh, there's some stuff there. But they can't... Oh, there's the well. Okay. Oh my god, so all the way back. Yeah, so we had to... We will have to create some... oral instruments contest. if I can say it like that. Between Chris and Outstar. So, can I? How can? Okay. Now I get why this was required. I have to lift the boat. Will it go? Oh, it goes. Yeah. Nope. A little bit more. Come on, ball, you're heavy. Please move. Please. Ah. Awesome. Awesome. Ta-da. Oh my god, we're cracking this. Amazing. Straight to the eye.
And take that! Bam! Say goodnight, Gracie! Uh-oh, we didn't break anything, did we?
Oh, let's hope we did not.
Maybe we can get out that way.
Aww, I wanted to go through the eye. Oh, come on.
I bet there's nothing actually broken. I bet it's just something you forgot to turn on.
Oh, do you know? Did I miss some luminaries? I think not. Like, I collected everything, right? Okay.
Figures, Daddy bought it. I bet there's just like one thing he forgot to do, and that's why the whole ride isn't working. It's probably in the control room, or the engine room, or something like that.
Aww, she's so smart.
Come on! It's dark out there. How are you gonna climb on shadows if it's dark?
Okay, okay.
Hey! This is that maintenance room I was talking about.
Ooh.
Why didn't Daddy do it? I bet he didn't even read the instructions.
Oh, come on. Your dad is not that.
Ride. I knew it! I knew it was something simple. I think all we need to do is pull these levers at the same time.
No, Didi. You're saying something simple is not that simple. What is this? The roller bearing assembles should be unpacked and greased every 80 operating hours. All cartridges and seals should be well lubricated, including the pores of the labyrinth. So, we have to lubricate stuff.
Are you ready?
No, it's a corrupted. Yeah.
Okay. 3, 2, 1, go!
Yeah, we made it.
I think we fixed it! I think we fixed the whole thing!
Perfect. Perfect. So, the pirate ship works. Amazing. Ha ha ha. Tortuga's revenge is online. Cool. So we have the last attraction, which is the carousel. What can I do in popcorn machine? where was the carousel? Wait a minute. Oh, what? Didn't I take this? Hmm. Oh, too far. I think it's jumping is enough, right? Oh, no. Come on. Yep, okay. Where is the carousel? Ah, right, here it is. Hey, Paddock 1234, are you from England?
It got snagged so they can't pull it down. But nobody can get up there to untangle it. I bet somebody didn't pay attention when he was tying it down.
Oh.
A carousel! Baby. I think I can turn it on. Do you have any luminaries?
I know I own you one thing, by the way. And I did not forget that. And actually, a new version came out for Lifeless Planet in some premium edition with enhanced graphics and sounds, apparently. So they have created some more new stuff in that game. Which I really want to try. And I will. As soon as I finish Contrast. Yeah. So the next game I will actually play on my channel will be Lifeless Planet.
Yay! Oh,
with Enhanced Edition.
Sorry.
No worries. Premium Edition, I'm sorry. That's how they call it.
Are you okay up there? You need any help? Here, jump on this!
Thank you.
I think you're gonna need to get that beacon working.
Alright, no problem. Since I made it here, I am already far away. Kent, okay. Yeah, actually, it's
now
the
you can
updated.
Get up to the roof and untangle Daddy's balloon.
The game has been updated, and I was looking into that. You know how when to stream that, and it's like, oh, what the hell is this update? And apparently, they just. Whoa, that's ended fast. Yeah, so they just, you know, put a bunch of stuff in there, which is pretty amazing, actually. It's no special edition. It doesn't cost anything. It's just an update. We are flying with the stars and falling down. Whoa. The horror, yeah, I agree with the horror elements. It might be, it could be a bit more horrific, but it's actually quite atmospheric already. So I imagine if you play it like quiet in your own room with lights off, it will be pretty. Oh shit. Pretty horrific, I imagine. Maybe not. So, what else we can do here? We have to go more. And tell me this is not a platformer game. See? This is a platformer game. Just put it in this nice. Can I actually dash? No, I can't. Yeah, Chris. Christy X4. That was. We were talking about Lifeless Planet. And I was explaining that I stumbled upon the update. Come on! ta-da! Yeah, and it was some premium edition which actually updated the graphics and the sounds, and they have new Russian voice actors, which actually already were pretty good. And yeah, it's strange that they changed them, or maybe they added some new ones, which is actually even more amazing, because I loved that bit a lot. Let's see. Oh, the balloon is there, so we have. What is this then? Yeah, and I'm planning to stream it after I will finish a Cyclops bottle. I have unlocked an achievement with a Cyclops bottle. I have no idea what that reference is to. Yeah, so I'll stream it after I'll be done with Contrast. I really hope that I will be done today. But as the first playthrough had some surprises, and it has three acts.
Yay!
I don't know if I'll...
Okay.
I don't know.
Hop in. I'll bring you back
what
now.
Will happen later.
That was amazing. I wish I could do that. Would you teach me someday?
Walking Sims. Yeah, that's a walking sim. No, it really has a pretty interesting story. It's a mixed up a bit. Jump, 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 jump around. What is that? Why are you sticking that stick
Vincenzo
to someone's?
Vincenzo came back!
Hey, what do you think, Vincenzo? Do you ever consider trying out for the trapeze?
They're good at what they do, Mr. Fenris. I'll give you that.
I got my balloon back, I got a princess for my puppet theater, and my pirate ship is sailing the bounding main.
So you're a man of your word.
Go ahead, count it. Mm-hmm. It's all there.
It's all yeah, about the money.
Your stuff.
My apparatuses are very delicate, and I don't like anyone in my workshop. You provide the audience, Mr. Fenris, and I will provide amazement.
Amazement.
Mr. Fenris, why are you organizing this circus? I know who your investors are.
I promised my wife and daughter I'd clean up my act.
But if I don't pull in the crowds for you, those boys are going to put you in the river.
Without Cat and Didi, I wouldn't care much if they did.
Ah.
So those crowds better come.
Better come.
I didn't talk to him. I didn't talk to Vincenzo.
So, Vincenzo is Didi's real father, the biological one. And this guy is her father, which she grew up with. I think Life That Plants is rather short. It is short. It's in total. Let me see. I streamed it for 2 hours and I then played maybe three more or maybe two. Around, like, I think in total you can spend like 6 hours or something like that in there. It's a story of the machine for pigs, even. I actually did not play that. I don't own that game. I don't really like those scary ones. Because I usually play like in the evenings and at nights, and for me it's like nope, I cannot. I played Metro Last Light. I could not finish that game.
Workshop.
Like seriously.
We finally talked to him all alone, but where is
was the girl who of you were following in Lifeless Plant?
Vincenzo, you know when he travels all around the world.
It's, I mean, how I should put this? It was kind of part of the planet
itself. Now we go this
itself,
way. Follow me.
But it took a form of human beings because of humans arrived in that planet. So that's why, and that's how I understood. Because it ended in a way that it could have mentioned this ending. Are these voices from Deus Ex? Yes, they are. And welcome, by the way, JMC82. Thank you for dropping by. And I lost Didi somewhere. Ah, okay, there she is. Look at her legs.
Excuse me, mister. Do you know where Mr. Vincenzo's workshop is?
Yep. Everybody knows where it is. It's by the big clock tower. You can't miss it. But good luck getting inside. No one's ever been.
Thank you. Come on!
No mentioning that. Oh, don't worry, we'll find a way to get in. Did I find something here, or is just for walking? Yeah, probably for walking. Okay. So nothing interesting here. Is it there? Is this the clock tower? Ah, okay, this is, oh, that one is an interesting tower. This is something else. So let's walk around. Maybe I'll find some, oh, yeah. I will find some good stuff. Ha. 104, oh my god, I missed so many luminaires back then.
He's in pretty deep with some bad people, Dee Dee. Maybe he should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Maybe I'm no good without my family. Maybe I need my family to make good.
Johnny, if this is another train...
I love this moment. Hey, girl, I'm jumping on your... on your face.
Promise.
I've missed you so much.
Oh, crap. No!
He's in pretty deep with some bad people, Dee Dee. Maybe he should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Oh, that's a huge gap, actually, I have to make.
Maybe I need my family to make good.
Johnny, if this is another train wreck, it's not just gonna...
I'm on your head, I'm on your head.
I've missed you so much.
Oh, I can... oh, I can grab a ledge there. Okay.
I'm pretty deep with some bad people, Dee. Maybe you should make good with them first. Right, Johnny?
Maybe I'm no good without my family. Maybe I need my family to make good.
Johnny, if this is another train wreck...
Ta-da! Made it. Nice. So it's 2 out of 4. Probably 2 will be somewhere here. Oh, there's one. Ah, so everything is around. That's nice. Maybe the 4th one is by the tower? Let's see. Oops. This is closed. Is in the bad shape. Okay, so 4th maybe hidden somewhere in Vincenzo's place. Oh, we have some more changes regarding the schedule in general.
Oh no, we
but
just
but we will actually
this is a big mechanism.
Announce it.
I hope you brought some luminaries with you.
Sometime later. It's just being worked out, guys, and you know, there's some a lot of Do you know what this is? I love this. I remember this from way, way back when the first 3D videos were being done, and this was one of the most amazing instruments I ever saw. You know, made in 3D, and there were pipes and bells, and everything was the balls were flying around, and yeah, that was amazing. Cool. Yeah, so for now some places are staying as they were, and the other ones are just moving a bit. So Vincenzo's solar machine. I'm wondering what the hell I have to do here. Something like this, maybe? And what do I do with the ball? Because I cannot jump in here, and I have to get... Oh, okay, so I have to get up there, and it seems that the ball has to go with me. Okay. This will be interesting. So I actually... Oh, crap. Whoa. So I have to get the ball up there somehow. What the f... Can I get it there? The ball? No. And this stuff. Oh yeah, maybe I can do it like this. Okay, let's see what happens. I made it. Oh, please don't fall off. Ah. Oh yeah, but the question is, so how will I get myself up there? Okay. After streaming last week before... It's hard to actually know when GOG.com starts the program. Yeah, so that's mainly why we are doing this. Oh, by the way, I see that my stream is like... dropping frames? In the video? Is it? Can someone confirm? Is it not smooth? Like, is it lagging behind? What the hell? It shouldn't be normal. Okay, so maybe it's just my laptop is not displaying video properly. Okay. Game does not like alt tabbing. Oh my god. Okay. So. Oh, that was easy. Probably I can jump something like... Hmm. No, this would be too low. Nah, this is... Hmm? Yeah, okay, that must be my laptop. It's an old one. Like, it's seriously, seriously old one. Yeah, so... for GOG... We kind of decided that it would be okay to tune up the schedule a bit, just to make it easier for everyone to understand what the hell is happening at what times. And I think probably it will work well. We'll see. All in all, if it will not, you know, we always can just change stuff around. That's not a problem. It's always just for convenience. Okay. Yay, we made it. Yeah, Chris is saying that with all the games on GOG, promos, releases, what you want to stream, what you can, and so many streamers who also have their life to tend to, it's hard to make it work. And it's true. It's really a lot of stuff is happening around, you know. Some people, for example, have their PCs as Chris does in the living room. So he has girl in there, right? And it's an issue sometimes to find a stream slot. For me, it's also sometimes I have to deal. Of course, I'm not streaming that much, so I found these spots in my schedule when I can actually do stuff without worrying. Yeah, but stuff is happening, you know. You want to go out somewhere, whatever. It's just yeah, a lot of people and a lot of things are changing. Sometimes even games are not working for stream, you know. They do not work with OBS or just don't want to work with that, and it has to be changed. So I think, to be honest, I think we are doing an awesome job as a team with all the streamers around, with all the different people, with all the different games that they're doing. So it's kind of works good. It works very good. From the other side, it's really, I imagine that it's really hard for you people, all the community people, to actually follow all these streams and all these changes, because they're happening so fast, and it's really hard to inform everyone. Just, oh, so, you know, it's like a half an hour before the stream, Outstar just poisons herself for no reason, or knocks herself out. Also sometime, right? Some other stuff is happening, you know, someone's PC is down. It's just life, right? Everything is happening. And you cannot predict that. And things will change, of course. But probably right now there will be a bit, maybe a bit different, and maybe a bit... but you will see, yeah. It will be all announced on GOG's channel, and you will see how it goes. Really hope every one of you will like it. Yeah, not a hero as... Yeah. Nox didn't stream. Wow. That's just surprising, actually. I remember Nox was kind of well-made game. Alright, let's get back into Vincenzo's place. What the hell? He has so many stuff here. Nice. This is nice. Is this some kind of microscope? Okay. Ooh. Science picture. Actually was, you know what, I was in the Copernicus Museum here in Warsaw. Ah yeah, I need to move there. And they actually had this ancient photo machine set up. So you could stand in one side of the room and the other one is looking on the other side and it's being transformed. So you're actually seeing someone upside down. But you're actually seeing it as people saw that at some point late, not late, but long time ago. Okay, probably I'll have to make something like this and get into that gap. The problem with Nox is it's using 16-bit colors and Alt-Tab and or mouse doesn't work. Game stays black. Yeah, that's probably. Really, Nox uses 16-bit? Oh my god, that was it like that long ago? Damn. So yeah, as I was talking about, you know, people. Oh, I didn't open the door. people having, you know. Other people living in the house and there's problems with setting it up. Yeah, so me too. You will see someone walking past me, so. Ah! Yes, I made it. Woohoo! Alright, this is cool. Now I am in someone's hand. Bah, okay. Conrad the second to, yeah. Yeah, well, you know, of course every streamer has their own games, right? The ones they like. Oops. Let's see. Yeah, this one. So they're also like not everyone can play everything, that's for sure. Like I cannot play, you know, horror games. Oh man, I forgot again. And we can leave that for Vlad. I'm also not very good at platformers, as you can all see. No, the Rogue Legacy was a terrible idea. Ah, yes. Oh, no! Why did I do that? Crap! So, all in all, you will see. Some changes coming It will not be that huge, actually, change. But it will be interesting to see. I hope really people will like it. God damn it. Nox is so old. So old. 2000. Oh my god, 2000. I feel so old right now. Oh my god. No, come on, concentrate. God damn it. I'm sorry, I was a bit distracted. But let me just get back into the move. Right. Okay. I have to dash and then... And then... Shift N again. Oop. No, why are you jumping so much? Come on. God damn it. I also can make faces. Come on, don't play games with me. Jump on that freaking hand. Ah, thank you. Now. Oh man, don't remember. Half a lifetime? Dude. Shit, that is true. That is seriously true. Okay. Jump. Oh! Yes! Yes! We made it! Awesome! Cool. So, today was... today is actually a holiday in Poland. It's the Saint Mary's Ascending to Heaven's Day for Christians. Ooh, that's a nice mechanism. But of course I will have to go up there myself. But how? Oh! Ooh, that's nice. And yeah, so speaking about holidays, today is the Saint Mary's Ascendance to Heaven's Day, whatever. I'm not Christian, so I have no idea what that means. But also, it was a Oh, come on, man. Also, it was the military parade in the streets of Warsaw, which was actually quite nice. It was actually quite nice, but now I was standing there. Ooh, some more science. I was standing there, you know, all those tanks were driving past, all the military machines. US soldiers, and I was thinking, no, why all this show? For what? For what reason? And I think they started that doing after like maybe 2 years already. And I really don't kind of realize why would you actually want to. Do this military parade. No, in terms of, okay, let's take Russia, right? For Russia, yeah, it's you know. Okay. They're. I just called them a police state. I'm sorry if that insults someone, but it's not my intention. But it's just how it works. And I understand them, you know, they have to show the power for people that they can defend them or whatever. But here in Poland, it's like, you know, they don't have a lot of military power, right? And it's playing, so I don't know, it's for people to be safe, for what, enemies to be afraid, for what is it for? What do you think? Like, do you have some kind of military parades in your countries? And what do you think about them? Ooh.
What are you doing here? Who are you? How did you get in?
Through the big clock.
You went through the clockwork? How? Who are you with?
It's a puzzle, right?
It's meant to keep strangers out.
It's a very good puzzle.
Not good enough, apparently.
But I'm not a stranger. I'm Didi. Didi Malenkaya.
Oh.
Didi Malenkaya.
Your mother put you up to this, didn't she?
You think so? I'm doing my homework.
Americans.
I wanted to meet you.
I didn't ask for a child, all right?
You didn't want a child?
What would I do with one? I'm a busy man. My apparatuses are precise. They take months to hone. How would I have the time? That is what I told her.
That's sad.
I'm sorry.
I travel. I'm going on tour for 6 months. Budapest, Istanbul, Calcutta, Shanghai. I dine out with dukes and gangsters.
But I could help you with your apparatuses. I'm good with puzzles. You could train me. I won't be any trouble.
You broke my left-handed induction coil. That took me a week to tune.
I'm sorry.
I told your mother all of this years ago. What is her phone number? Okay, see? This is what I'm talking about. This is what I can't have. Your mother cried every week.
Yeah, because you're a fucking huge asshole.
You're
maybe
better off with Kat. A little girl should be with her mother.
Okay.
All right. Do you want to come to see my show?
No!
Well, here's two tickets in case you change your mind.
Hey!
Let's get Kat on the phone,
Oh, Didi will begin trouble again. Damn. If you have cool, impressive stuff, you can show it off, but... Oh man. So apparently OBS might have decided not to stream anymore for some reason. But I think I am back. Okay, yeah, that's cool. Yeah, so I'm sorry, I don't remember Grievix where you are from. Carnahill says, in Poland it's important to move those machines every now and then, so they don't trust. Oh yeah, man. Yeah, that's true. Großer Zapfenstreich. Zapfenstreich. Ah, Belgium. Yeah. Yeah, but that's a little country, right? So they don't have lots of military. Wait, back at the stage. Where's the back of the stage? I think somewhere there. Oh no, wait. This is the tower. Oh, here, back of the stage. Alright.
What do I do with you? Lock you up? Put bars on the windows? I can't stay at home all night and watch you.
Who's
the
third girl?
I'm not one of those secretaries who punch out at 5. I'm a rising star, right? Did Johnny know about this?
The Germans.
Because I'm gonna kill him.
I just wanted to talk to him.
Come on, it's enough Germans.
I never should have let him back. I just needed. Just wanted.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Vincenzo's Theater of the Unreal.
He's like Tesla. Oh.
I knew it. I knew this was another one of Johnny's pipe dreams. You screwed up again, didn't you?
Oh,
Johnny,
that's...
what's going on? Is this part of the show?
I got it.
Yeah, they're getting antsy. They're gonna want their money back.
If you give them their money back, you can't pay us.
It's all under control. I just gotta go find a spare bulb. Fuse. Something.
Why can't he get anything right? We're gonna have to fix this one too.
Oh, yes, we will. We will.
Darn it. We need to light up the stage somehow.
Oh, so now we're going to the lighthouse. Alright. So Mr. Vincenzo was so right about himself, and he required such a perfection from everything. And now his Tesla coils just blew up. Like that. Bam! At the start of the show. Terrible, right?
This is a weird lighthouse. Do you think it's some kind of science lab? It reminds me of Vincenzo's workshop.
Man, that is such a
bad
shape.
I think this is what lights up the lights up there. Let me see if I can fix it.
Ooh, this is something new. So... so apparently I have just to... oh my god. Oh crap, what the... what? Okay. Let's see what this gets us. You know, I really like how this game actually introduces all the new mechanics in the game just like that. Okay, can I operate this? No, but I need this in the other way, please. Oh, that's a very small gap for me. Okay, let's try again. Ooh, okay. Damn it. So Okay, so I can jump here. But how the hell I should... How should I pass this? No, come on, Gavin. Probably here, but... Can I make it like this? Oh, I can almost walk through that. Okay. Okay. Maybe I can try to bug the game out. Ah, that would be interesting. Oops. Let's try this maybe a bit higher. Maybe this will work. Ooh. Crap. So how should I do that? So maybe it's the other way. But there's like nothing here, just one gap. No, this will be too far. I cannot make it this far. I need this box. Please let me take this. Huh. It's... Maybe. Let's see. Can I move it like this? Maybe if I will shine the light straight into the box. Shift in, drop the box, shift out, just... So that worked, okay. What did you just do? So I can carry the box and... Ooh, that is nice. Nice. Okay, this is very awesome. This is really, really amazing. To see that also. Oh my god, what is that? That's a double bicycle with a machine gun? God damn it. Another link is Belgian machine guns pulled by dogs. Wow. Come on, what do you want from a small country, people? That's amazing. That's amazing that they actually can, you know, think. What is this? Wow, this is like a US Marine Corps bike, an armored bike. With two miniguns on the sides. Oh my god, that weighs so much. Wow. Alright. Yeah, those are some amazing links. Well, muzzles are required for dogs in most cases, just because, you know, when they become afraid, they make not nice stuff. Can I do something to it? No? Okay. I will have to move there. Apparently. Yeah, well, the shadow puzzles are fiddly. I would agree. That's true. It's oh crap. Oh, made it. Of course it will not stay in that side. Shit. They are unusual. They are very, very unusual. And it's, you have to get used to that. I think that you really have to get used to that, because it's not so standard. Ugh, so I have to go back. Come on. See, it's just easy to die. You know, the concept of shadows is really, really nice. I really like the concept of this. Could they make something more out of this? Yes, they could. Of course they could, because it has very, very big potential. And this idea actually has a very big potential. And if made probably in a better way, it might be a very, very good game. Picture of girl's shadow beside a woman walking down the sidewalk. There's already X-Files going on. Now it's a mix of platformer, puzzle, story, adventure. It's like a mix of a lot of genres of games, and I don't know, it makes me feel amazed and confused at the same time. I don't know. Darkness says that the Russian anti-tank dogs didn't have muzzles. I will not comment on this. No, well, you know, you cannot compare Russians and Belgians. It's just, they have such a different state of mind. It's investigation into the multiverse via mystical experiences. Wow. This is getting really, really weird. Oh my god, what the hell? See ya, Podak. Thank you for joining me. Hell March. Yeah, the Russian, I remember something, that the Russian anti-tank dogs are the dogs who are actually were sent to with the just plain bombs straight to the tanks. So naturally they just exploded when they reached them. Ooh, so the mom of Didi. Huh. What is this? Iliescu family tree. Oh, look, and there's Didi Malenkaya, Vincenzo, Iliescu. Is this like... received exorcism, admitted to St. John's Asylum. It looks like... Well, I want to read that. That was interesting. Scotland Yard is searching for a noted illusionist, Mr. Arthur Iliescu, in connection with the disappearance of his magician's assistant, Miss Aurora Rose, late of Chipping Norton. Miss Rose was last seen on stage at the Baker Street Theatre during Mr. Iliescu's famous illusion act. Mr. Iliescu is well known for making his pretty assistants disappear and reappear. On the evening of October 28th, however, he neglected to fulfill the second part of his act. Detained by police, Mr. Iliescu proclaimed his own bafflement at Miss Rose's failure to return to the stage per modus operandi. She's supposed to vanish into thin air, stated Mr. Iliescu, but she's supposed to come back. Police Inspector Gilles Lestrade determined no sign of foul play. Indeed, police found no sign whatsoever ever of the continued physical existence of Miss Rose on the mortal plane. Why do you mention mortal plane even? Wow, Mr. Iliescu was released from custody on Thursday. Now it would appear he, too, has gone missing. Mr. Iliescu's performances at the Baker Street have been cancelled. And the hotel, the Blackstone, has not seen him since shortly after his release. The belongings remain in his room, and mysteriously, the maids report that some of his clothes have been displaced by a party of parties unknown. And even the mystery is involved in this game. Oh, so this is the lighthouse part, okay. Hey, Japudding, welcome. How's your night shift? Oh, so it's timed. Crap, and I was waiting until it will repeat. No! Wrong button. Crap. Didn't want to do that. And again, please. Okay. What is happening there? I have no fucking idea. I think they're the stones you are hearing outside. Picture depicting the shadow dimension's effect on world. Huh. What do you mean you survive your night shift and the day shift? Dude, did you even sleep? What the hell? What are you working that you have two shifts at the same time, man? That's bad. So apparently someone was actually researching the shadow stuff. And it's kind of like real and not real. Hmm. this is getting more and more. Oh, so I can do only. Okay. Where do I have to go? I don't know where to have to go. Alright. Oh, sure, of course, I had to take the box. What? Yeah, achievement unlocked. Bookkeeper. Ha! Picture of Vincenzo and Dawn. Oh, wait, so that's the character I'm playing. 1900s. So I'm wait, what? I'm actually related to the Vincenzo guy? So am I that assistant? Wow, there's a lot of stuff. I have no idea what to do here. I have the box. But I can't do anything with it. Oh, no, I can. No, I can't. So, people are not chatting that much, you know, as in GOG streams. What the hell did I just do? The box. Oh my god. I just lost the box. How can I move this? I just can't see that. Okay. Yeah, but that's the maximum it will go. Damn it. Lift it up now and onto the ledge. Well, maybe, yeah, but which ledge? just... Oh, okay. I just kind of did not notice that there is a focus thing. No, this will help us. Okay. This is much easier. Ta-da! Yeah! Progress! Progress, people! See, they're not so clunky, these puzzles. This is a bit loud. Go. Whoa. What is that? Damn it. Oh, at least the box is there. Cool. That is cool. Nope. Why are you sucking me in? I just did not press anything. Come on. Let's say that was intentional. Hey, Jipudin, really nice of you to join me, especially after these two difficult night shifts and day shifts. No, I have to put the box down first, then I have to jump out. Move! Why are you not moving? No! Why is it sometimes stuck? Christiax4 says, I hope YouTube's gaming's launch gives Twitch the motivation to sort out their technical issues. Yeah, I really hope also. And probably they're working very, very much in terms of actually bringing that up, because that's a huge announcement. They actually have pretty... No, okay, I don't know. They have very good streaming in terms of video streaming, but they don't have good things for community stuff. So for me, their chat is just piece of crap, to be honest. They don't have any moderation tools and stuff, so it's kind of, you know, a bit I have to run back. They're still a bit underprepared. But I think they're going in the right direction, and this is really, really, this will kick Twitch's ass in terms of for them to just be a bit more, what the hell, on to their problems. Of course, these problems are just, you know, natural project problems. You cannot do anything more about that. Okay, so that didn't shift. That slipped away. Well, how many tries it will take for me? 3. Very nice. Yeah, well, they're not working on chatty and stuff, right? But should they? All in all, this is like... Oh, that was fast. This is a part of community project. Oh, what was that? Was that some kind of a dream? Oh, this is from the lighthouse, okay. That's a nice little world.
After a few days, the princess got to wondering.
Why her dad kept trying to give her away?
Man, the memories. No, nothing here. Go around. This looks very nice, really. It's really, really nice.
You think
nicely
you're gonna
made.
Jitterbug your way back into our lives with a lot of sweet talk?
That's the past, cannot change.
That's the past, cannot change. This is really nice.
You're not even a real father.
I missed you so much.
I missed you too, honey.
Yeah, sure, you can't pop out the chat and, well, you know, it's like they're kind of focusing on the stream stuff, right? Not the community interaction and all that stuff. I mean Twitch. In terms of YouTube, they for now don't have anything yet. Well, they have the live streaming, by the way, and it's really, really good. I really like their live streaming. They have very good quality. To shine on Vincenzo's show, right? There we go. There we go. Achievement unlocked. Let there be light. Alright. So let's see his show.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the amazing Vincenzo's Theater of the Unreal.
I got the lights on.
We'll talk about this after.
Ladies and gentlemen, a physicist named Albert Einstein tells us that our universe may not be the only one. There may be infinite others, each slightly different from ours.
Ooh.
What are dreams in our world may be reality in those. To citizens of these other worlds, we are shadows. This appears to you to be an ordinary box, but it is actually what we call a tesseract, or an octachoron. Suppose I open it, not in the three dimensions we live in, but along its fourth dimension. I can take out surprising things. Things that are familiar and yet strange.
So it's like the world that Dawn is. Dawn
but in this world of shadows, what seems familiar may be dangerous.
They see the other world as shadows.
What you don't know can hurt you. But what frightens you can also turn into something of surpassing beauty if you only understand it.
That's creepy.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
That was creepy.
Goodbye.
This was very... huh.
What are you up to, Johnny? You're up to something, aren't you?
I tried, Kat. I really tried. Mom was right. I made a lot of promises I couldn't keep.
What is with you?
Without you, I'd be in the river.
But it worked out, Daddy.
I nearly got you hurt, kiddo.
You would have saved me if I needed it.
You know, the strangest thing that the Dawn character is actually not saying anything at all. Nothing.
Enjoy the show.
I want you to meet the little girl who turned the lights back on.
You made the lighthouse work?
I fixed the puppet show, too. And the pirate ship.
You fixed the pirate ship?
It was only a little broken.
See? She's almost as smart as you. Of course, she's brave, too.
What's that supposed to mean?
That you're rich, famous, and afraid of a little girl.
What would you have me do, Mr. Fenris? Take her on my world tour? Take her to Shanghai and Istanbul and those other filthy and dangerous cities as some sort of apprentice? Is that what you came here to propose?
Daddy, no!
I don't know, just... Dee Dee deserves better. They both deserve better. They need you.
I think they need you.
Me? I'm a walking calamity.
No, Daddy, we need
you. You risked your life to be with them.
Johnny, what did you do?
He nearly got himself killed to get you back. I wouldn't do that for anybody.
But I'm just gonna keep screwing up.
I can help you fix things.
Would you take me back? For good?
Such a drama.
Oh, Johnny.
Would you like to see my workshop? Again?
What? Yeah.
I bet you get to Shanghai on your own steam.
But how?
Well, you'll figure something out. After all, you are my daughter.
How'd you do that? I thought only Dawn could do that.
It's been a long time, hasn't it? Thanks for taking care of Dee Dee.
What? See, you... Ta-da!
No matter what I do,
there you go, people. There you go.
I don't mind.
Is my character Tito Fedor Jensen and Lady with Massive? Yeah. No.
But I try not to dream.
She's related to Vincenzo. She was her assistant. And actually, the newspaper article that I read before was about her and Vincenzo. So they actually could shift to the shadow world. And the shadow world was like they were real in there, but the other world was as shadows. And they could switch between those two planes, apparently. Yeah, and I don't know. I'm kind of with a lot of open questions, like, so why did she do that? I don't know. All in all, it's yeah, it was really, really a nice an interesting game. Very nice. I love the concept. I missed two collectibles. My God, and I missed three achievements. I wonder which. Aha, all collectibles in Act 2. Not that kind of game is unlocked when player tries to enter with the XXX door. And, and the one that avoids jump. Yeah. I agree. The ending was weird. Seriously, it's like premature for me. You say you're sorry, although that's one of the rare games that I can actually end and complete and Mr. Chief says that collectibles. Nah, whatever. I'm not sick. In this terms of collecting everything, it's more of the games actually forcing you to do that from time to time, right? Assassin's Creed, for example, that's an insane collectible game. I really love the soundtrack. Unfortunately, Steam doesn't give you that. And the one place you can find that is only in YouTube. Yeah, so here's where they actually, the Vincenzo and the Dawn are together, which there's the tie between them. So he was actually, I imagine that Vincenzo was actually researching the thing about this shadow stuff. And at some point, Dawn just, I don't know, disappeared probably from that? Or something like that? And then, you know, they just kind of connected somehow? But it really, really leaves a lot of questions in here, in terms of story. There's like tons of holes in here. But I think this game was not about the story, it was more about the concept, it was more about these shadow things and how you play with that, and yeah, I really enjoyed it. It was really a nice game. So if you want to... No, what am I doing? I just played that game through for you, right? yeah, of course Steam doesn't ship the extras for the game. Anyway, you know, GOG will start shipping them will start shipping AAA games at some point in their lives. So, yeah, cool. That was amazing. I thought I will have to do more of this, but nice. I loved it. Really, that was cool. I just finished the game on stream, my first one. The Witcher will end probably next Monday or maybe the next Monday, so that will take a bit of time. There is a collector's edition with this game. Okay, that's nice. I don't know if I would buy a collector's edition. Well, unless it will be a decent price, because it's like 4-hour game. Really, I played it in two streams. It was 2 hours each. You know, with talking and all that stuff, so It's a short game. I wouldn't pay a lot of money for that. But the soundtrack is very good, and I can't upgrade. Yeah, that's Steam for you guys. Anyways, thank you very much for joining me. My name is Donis. If you don't follow me, please do. If you like this, on Twitch, here where you are, on Twitter, twitter.com/donisplays. Cool. So I will be back on Monday on GOG's channel. I will also be on GOG's channel next week with a release stream on Wednesday, and I will come back on my channel on Saturday with the Lifeless Planet, the premium edition. Yeah, so thank you very much. Oh, Lindy Chan! Oh, I'm sorry, you just... Damn, you just missed my 2 hours. Oh, right, I forgot. Thank you, Chris. Chris TX4. Yes! Okay, so wait a minute. Next week will be so intensive for me. Because I was a bit out. I will say on Monday why. Some of you may know, may not know. Yeah, so tomorrow... Oh my god, I just forgot everything. No, this is why GOG streams are so impromptu, you know, think of something, okay, let's do it like right now, and it's done, and you just forget about this, it's just in calendar and that's it. Okay, so tomorrow... Oh, the hell part, no, this is a different one. Come on, browser, please work. Okay, so my schedule for next week. Oh my god, 4 streams per week, damn it. Yes, so at 8 PM GMT and 10 PM CEST, we will be playing Victor Rand co-op. And this will be probably a series with me, Outstar, Screaming Joypad, and Memories in 8-Bit, Chris. So this will be tomorrow in the evening. So on Monday at... Oh, this is Tuesday. Oh, I was so afraid it... Someone removed that. Yeah, so on Monday, 6 PM GMT, on GOG's channel. Both of them will be on GOG's channel. So I will be trying to finish The Witcher Wild Hunt, and it will be episode number 13. I really hope I'll manage to do that, but it might be a need for 14 one. On Wednesday, at 8 PM GMT, I will be streaming Hacknet, the release stream. So this is a new game. And on after a week, and Saturday, I will be streaming Lifeless Planet on my own channel. So this is for me for next week. I thank you again for joining me. My name was Donis, and I will see you tomorrow on GOG's channel. So, ciao, and thank you again for joining me. Have a nice night.
Oh, I wish we had the soundtrack.